have worked together with a utility in Denmark called Aarhus Water for quite some years, and they have in fact created amazing results with what we nowadays call digitalization. And that means basically using a lot more sensors and a lot more wireless speed drives than we normally see. What they have gained is the first place for 200,000 people living in the city where they don't use any energy. And how were they able to do that? They have been through the whole water cycle. That means on the drinking water side, they have been looking at how they could split the city into pressure zones. And by splitting the city into pressure zones, you lower the pressure in the whole network. And what you gain out of that is typical 20 to 40% energy saving. Besides that, you reduce your leakage quite dramatic. So they are down on 6% in leakage on the drinking water side, whereas you on a global level will see 25 to 30% leakage. So here you will see that taking care of water scarcity and making your CO2 neutral or cutting down on your energy go hand in hand. It's part of the same coin. That they have done through the whole water cycle then, and also especially on the wastewater facility, ending in a result that the wastewater facility is producing 234% energy. That means 134% more energy than it needs for cleaning the wastewater itself. And it is existing facilities where they have optimized it by implementing a lot more sensors, for instance pressure sensors and a lot more variable speed drive and smart process control. So the good thing is that you don't need to build new facilities. You can go into existing facilities and obtain these amazing results that you both are completely energy neutral. And at the same time, you're cutting your leakage down to, for instance, 6% as they are in Aarhus. So that is, in my book, a lighthouse project on a global scale. One of the bad things for the utility is that they have a lot of visitors. But I think they are happy about that.